In this video, we'll cover Sysdig troubleshooting to discover and then uncover root cause. So let's say you're deploying a new web application into your production Kubernetes cluster. The app uses Nginx containers as proxy front ends to receive and relay user requests to a Flask container serving as a web REST backend. Your team receives a Sysdig monitor alert informing them of a pod crash restart loop in your environment. This condition, known as crash loop backoff, is a well-known error to most Kubernetes users. It means that a Kubernetes pod is experiencing successive pod restarts within a short period. The challenge? There can be many different causes. So when a pod is in this crash loop backoff state, app performance may be significantly degraded or even out of service until resolved. So when the alert fires, Sysdig creates a capture file containing all of the system call information. The ability to automate system captures is unique to Sysdig. No other solution provides an integrated troubleshooting capability with the wealth of deep system data available, even after containers or pods are gone. Another quick thing to point out is that you can click through the alerts page to see all of the notifications belonging to this very same alert that have happened in your environment. In the capture files page, we find the associated capture and can click on the hyperlink name to access its contents. So when we click on the link, Sysdig Inspect automatically opens. In the overview page, we see a summary of all of the available system information, the metrics and the events, all represented here by tiles that enable us to further drill down in order to analyze the problem. We can see here at a glance that some containers died and were restarted. Let's click on the Container Died Events tile and narrow our view to drill down and see more. Here we can see what containers are impacted. Our Nginx containers are having trouble. Looking at the timestamps, we can see that these containers die shortly after being created. We know our Nginx containers only execute one process, that is Nginx. So next, let's go to Processes, and we'll filter by proc.name equals Nginx. From here, we can click on IO streams to see what was happening to that process before dying. We can now see the issue. Host not found in upstream Flask, and so on. Right, we're also shown the file containing the error. It's the nginx.conf file indicating the problem lies with the Nginx configuration. Sysdig Monitor and Sysdig Inspect have taken us from an alert all the way to showing us the issue, and now it tells us where we can look to fix the problem, the nginx.conf file. The key takeaway here is that capture files provide a wealth of data, including inter-process communication, files written, network activity, all enriched with container-specific context. With a few clicks, you can identify affected containers and what went wrong, so you can quickly take corrective action. Thanks for watching.